To have a good offense, you must first have a good defense. Senior captain and linebacker Edwin Jackson is going through a good period in his football career with the Georgia Southern Eagles. He had his first career interception against South Alabama and helped defeat longtime rivals Appalachian State. What most people do not know is that Jackson was a walk-on in 2011, but since then has made a tremendous effort to establish himself as a key element in the Eagles' defensive line. We sat down with Jackson for an interview to ask him what brought him to Georgia Southern and how his time with the Eagles has developed.
Here at Georgia Southern, they have a great tradition. And just being very close in Atlanta, I hear a lot about Georgia Southern. And at first, I didn't know where I wanted to go, but I had an older brother that really instilled in me and said, you know, hey, you should walk on at Georgia Southern. They have a great football team, and they also have a great school and great academics.
So being a walk-on player, what was your motivation to get to this point to where you are now?
Well, I always had the motto saying, you know, if you want something, go get it, but you have to understand what comes with it. And I feel like that really drove me on. You know, I have great family members and great family support. So every time I do something good and I tell my parents, they feel very proud of me, and I have a lot of siblings, so I'm a leader in the family, and I want to instill that in front of my younger siblings.
How did it feel to have your first career interception against South Alabama for Georgia Southern's inaugural conference match?
It was amazing because I knew my parents, they couldn't make it to the game, but I knew they were watching on ESPN. And I feel that my brothers, they also was very proud of me because we practiced those exact plays in practice. My coaches were definitely happy and not surprised, but they were very happy for me. And I feel like those same routes and same play that we practiced in practice, we looked at that film and we studied for that. So, I mean, we really were ready for that play.
I know you had never beaten Appalachian State, so what was your reaction to Thursday's game? You had the second largest crowd at the Paulson Stadium, so how did it feel?
It was amazing. All week I was looking at old highlights, and some I was in the highlights, and some I wasn't there, but I knew that it meant a lot to the guys that left before us. And I told some of the guys that are here now, it's not for us. It's for the guys that were in the past, those past 3 years that we lost. And I feel like it was a very emotional game for me because this is my last year and this is my last time playing App State. And I didn't want to have that doubt. I didn't want to have that regret saying I could have did more in practice. So all week of practice with the coaches, we strive for the best. And every day we play like it was a championship game. And when we went out there, we gave great effort and we got what we worked for.
As a captain, what do you try to transmit to the other players?
That you can't get anything back. Time is continuing on, and I feel like you have to get every day of practice is day. It might be raining, we might have to practice inside, but it might be a full mental day, but you have to be mentally focused. And then when it's a physical day, just giving all you got, because you're never going to get that time back. Every day counts, and every day is a process of being the best team and the best player.
Is there a ritual you do as a team or individually before each game?
We have a lot of rituals here. The best, I think, is the bus ride. I always get geared up, and my hair stands straight up when we do that. But as a personal ritual, I thank the Lord once I get up. I get a healthy breakfast. I get in, I talk to my teammates, and I try to be real quiet and listening to my music. But I think the biggest thing is just talking to my teammates and looking in their eyes, knowing that they're ready to play, and I'm ready to play for them.
What has been the highlight of your career so far?
The highlight of my career? I was probably going back to Atlanta and seeing my family there and far friends coming all to Atlanta and just seeing the effort that we fought back with. I know we had a first half, but being out there on the field with my brothers and seeing them get that great effort, that championship effort, and just have that will to win. And that's something I really enjoy, just being out there on my field with my brothers, because we work all day, every day, you know, on the practice fields. So when we go out there on the game day, we know who's got our back, and we very much so displayed that on Saturday.
What are your expectations for the rest of the season, and do you have any personal goals you would like to accomplish?
For the rest of the season, I just wish that, you know, we win every game. That's what we're here to do. I mean, here at Georgia Southern, our tradition here is winning, and that's what we want to continue to instill on the future generations. For personal goals, I just want to finish my year off strong and just leaving that mark that great guys before me did, like Brent Russell, Jerick McKinnon, J.J. Wilcox, John Stevenson. Those guys really instilled here at Georgia Southern that hard work pays off, and every day is another day to get better. We have great coaches here, and they teach us that, you know, great effort, championship effort, taking care of the football, getting the football out. Those are just things we do every day, and if you continue to practice those things, you're going to be perfect.
This is Cesar Perez for Sunbelt on Campus, Georgia Southern.